Welcome back to the second half of Under the Rock. I'm still your host, Ben Packer, and senioritis got me feeling like a slacker.
And I'm Lindsay Santella, making my debut on the show.
Welcome aboard, Lindsay. We've got a lot in store for you today, including the Interact Fashion Show,
the conclusion of winter sports, as well as the upcoming of spring sports,
the GRHS walkout,
and so much more.
Yeah, I really like your shirt today.
Thanks, Ben. I got it from Lord & Taylor, one of the stores that sponsored the Interact Fashion Show.
Oh my god. The dresses from the fashion show were beautiful. The guys looked alright, too.
Yeah, the Interact Club performed the annual fashion show in the cafeteria on March 14th.
My fellow classmate Rachel McMahon said, "The fashion show is a way to get everyone excited for prom season." She also mentioned that it is a great way to enter spring.
The show consisted of performers shredding down the runway in two different style of prom dresses that the girls may want to wear. The best part is all the money was raised was given to the American Cancer Society Hope Lodge.
That's so cool. I wish I could have shred down the runway with all my friends.
I shred onto the basketball court.
Speaking of basketball, didn't the girls play in a state tournament game?
Yeah, I think they did. Let's see how well all the winter sports teams did over at the sports desk with Cole Gibney and Eden Kennedy.
Hello everyone, I'm Cole Gibney.
And I'm Aiden Kennedy. Welcome to the Sports Desk.
The Glen Rock girls basketball team competed in the NJSIAA North Jersey Section 1 Group 2 State Tournament on February 27th and March 1st. The girls won the first round game against Elmwood Park, 50-34, but unfortunately lost in the second round, 41-31 against Lakeland. Junior Ashley Robinson led the team with 15 points against Elmwood Park, and junior Caitlin Dooner led the team with 8 points against Lakeland.
Man, these girls had a great season.
Speaking of great seasons, how about that boys' hockey team? I dug deep into Glen Rock's playoff push, and here's a story of their everyday grind to the finish.
After a solid regular season and an early exit in the county tournament, Glen Rock's hockey team became the number 4 seed in the state tournament. They won games against Montville and Ramsey to advance to the semifinals versus number 1 seed Summit on February 28th at Coney Arena in West Orange. The team lost 2-0 against Summit as many students from Glen Rock High School watched from the stands. Glen Rock's team won the state championship last year, so it would have been a great accomplishment to win it back-to-back years. This team is very tightly bonded together, and Mac Alvino, a freshman backup goalie from the team, explained how. The boys cherished their last ride home, realizing we wouldn't be together with that group again, and it was more like a celebration at the end, like a funeral. Glen Rock's goalie, senior Ryan McCauley, had 16 saves on 17 shots and played well. The other goal was on an empty net shot with about a minute left to seal Summit's victory. The referees also made a few questionable calls, which Glen Rock's whole team and the fan base were unhappy with. The team was like a family, and the seniors leaving will leave a hole in the hockey organization. Mac Alvino once again elaborates on how devastating this loss was by saying, "The guys were in disbelief that this ride was finally over after putting in so much work all year. It felt surreal that it was done now. The players will be hungry to come back strong next year and make another playoff push." This wasn't the end of our winter sports success. The track team ran away with their first Group 1 state title ever.
For the first time ever, on February 10th, the winter track team won the North 1 Group 2 state sectional title for both boys and girls. This was the first time in 15 years that Glen Rock High School has won a state sectional title for track and field. This year, the seniors started to take the winter season more seriously and wanted to win more meets. The team wanted to go far and finish with a state sectional title. Senior Selma Sose said, "We went into the season, into the meet, cool and confident, and just performed well because we were in a good state of mind mentally." Finishing with this win, seniors Rachel and Selma were excited for their team to build off this win and prepare for next season. Senior Rachel McMahon said, "They are a young team but can have a lot of success and potential." The winter track coach, Coach McCartan, said, "It all started on day one, right in the beginning of the season, when the seniors called me in for a meeting on all the meets they wanted to win. The team looks forward to the next season and continuing with this success." Wow, what a story. The wrestling team also took down some big opponents under the bright lights during the winter. We have more on that story now.
4 Glen Rock High School students participated in the NJSIAA Wrestling Region 1 tournament from February 21st to February 24th at New Milford High School. led by Coach Corey Fitzpatrick and assistants Jose Vega and Ben Duronio. Seniors Kyle Fisher and Jacob Slump, along with sophomores Greg Shillette, each won their first match, with Shillette taking fifth place in the 160-pound weight class. Senior Jimmy Gilmartin lost in the qualifying round. According to Fisher, in preparation for the tournament, the team has two practices with nationally ranked Bergen Catholic. 2 years ago, which was the last time he made it, he went to Pascack Hills to practice with Fitzpatrick's former team. Despite all of the work that Fisher, Slump, Gilmartin, and Shillette put in over the past season, none of them were able to become the first Glenrock High School wrestler to make it to the state tournament in Atlantic City since the team's co-op with Saddlebrook. Greg Shillette hopes to become the first state champion wrestler in school history. The general feeling of all the wrestlers can be best summed up with a quote from Greg Shillette when asked how he felt about the way that his season ended. The sophomore responded by saying, "It was definitely a kick in the ass."
Here are some updates on the latest games.
Baseball won their last game 7-0 at home against Jefferson.
Softball won their last game against Demarest 1-0 in a close game on the road.
The boys' tennis team beat Garfield 5-0.
The boys' basketball team had one last scrimmage at the end of the year. On March 25th, the boys' basketball varsity team scrimmaged BBB, also known as Big Baller Brand, a basketball team consisting of juniors and seniors at Glenrock High School. The varsity team won 39-38 in the near upset by BBB. Senior Ben Packer, who plays for BBB, said, "I'm honestly so surprised we almost beat them, considering we never had a practice and only had six kids, but it was a good game and they were tough competition."
Wow, what a great way to end the season.
I'm Cole.
And I'm Aiden. Now back to Ben and Lindsay.
Thanks, Cole and Aiden. All the winter teams really ended their season on a high. Let's hope that the spring teams do just as well.
Sports aren't the only important thing happening here at Glenrock High School.
True. Let's see what's going on at the news desk with Justin DeSasso and Brianna Frenino.
Hi, I'm Justin DeSasso.
And I'm Brianna Fornino, and welcome to the Under the Rock News Desk.
The freshman and 8th grade class had an informational assembly about cyberbullying on Friday, February 23rd. Principal John Arlotta said the meeting behind the assembly is to educate students on what could happen on the social media platforms. The assembly included information on the different ways cyberbullying starts and a variety of different platforms that it happens. Taylor Rogers, a freshman student, said the assembly was an eye-opener, because cyberbullying is a major problem that is snowballing. The assembly ended with many stories and videos of other people who have been cyberbullied.
What a good topic to talk about, especially today with all the social media apps.
Yeah, it really was.
Another interesting thing that happened was the DECA Club going to States in Atlantic City on February 27th to March 1st. The DECA Club had 5 successful finalists who made it to the national championship. Club received a Diamond Award for dramatically growing membership from the year prior. Pat Williams, a junior student, says kids who like business can practice their role and which incorporates business aspects. The object of DECA is to prepare and emerge leadership and entrepreneurship. Benner Chen, a junior student, says we got to go into serious business situations and it gave us a good outlook to the business world. Both say the presentations were very competitive and the atmosphere of the meeting was very intense. Best of luck at Nationals.
Speaking of luck, not everyone has been very lucky this winter and has been affected by the flu virus. People across the country have been impacted by the flu this past winter, including here at Glenrock High School. The flu usually takes place during the late fall or winter and can infect anyone. High school nurse Miss Leone stated that only a small percent of students were affected, but you still want to be careful. Casey Bedwell Cole, a student at the high school, was affected by the flu in December. When asked how the flu affected her performance in school, she said, "It was really difficult to keep up with all my schoolwork due to the amount of days I missed." Casey explained that she will now stay away from people who have the flu and will be more aware. Miss Leone suggests that you get your yearly flu shot to prevent you from the virus.
Moving on from the winter seasons and the flu, the Glenrock High School's theater company performed their spring scenes on March 22nd to March 24th in the Glenrock High School auditorium. Unlike the fall play, the spring scenes is made up of many different short plays. Every member of the theater company was assigned at least one small cast. Mrs. Montabano, the head of the theater company, said if the plays are a little shorter, it gives the student directors more time to really work on them. Senior director Isabella Crawford commented, "I have to consider my actors and their limits, getting costumes and props, and being able to get everything together." The cast rehearsed twice a week for 3 weeks and planned on rehearsing every day during the week leading up to the show. However, weather issues got in the way. A snowstorm hit Glenrock, causing Glenrock schools to be closed on Wednesday, March 21st, interfering with their schedule. Because of this, the cast and crew were let out of their classes at 11:50 on Thursday in order to get one last rehearsal.
Speaking of people coming together, on March 14th at 10 a.m., Glenark High School took part in the walkout along with many other schools around the country to protest the way the government is handling gun control laws. History teacher Mrs. Walters spoke at an assembly about the walkout. She talked about activism and the importance of student voices and taking action. Mrs. Walter talked to reporter Maya Gross about her hopes for the walkout and its effect on history. She told Maya, "I hope that it reinvigorates American democracy and that kids recognize their impact on student activism."
This balloon is for Alyssa Al-Hada.
She is
age 14. This balloon is for Scott Beagle, age 35.
After the walkout, Maya talked to some of the students at GRHS. Many stated that the 17 minutes were very unorganized and should have been used better. Junior Lizzie Hoyt told Maya what she thought the walkout should have been. She said, "I think it was about showing solidarity to the states that don't have good gun control laws."
Wow, I'm really glad that everyone came together to protest the way the government is handling gun laws.
Yeah, me too. Now back to Lindsay and Ben.
Wow, it seems like a lot of important events are happening at Glenrock in the last few months.
Yeah, for real. But Lindsay, quick riddle. I have a head and no body, but I do have a tail. What am I?
I don't know. A bug?
No. It's a coin. Let's see if the other Glenrock students can solve some other ones.
Hi, I'm Ben Packer, and today I'm going to be going around the school asking people questions, hoping to trick some people. Let's get it. All right, first question. What's heavier, a pound of cotton or a pound of stones?
Is the cotton wet?
Yeah, the cotton's wet.
Pound of cotton.
Pound of cotton.
Pound of cotton.
Pound of cotton or a pound of stones? You're saying a pound of cotton is heavier than a pound of stones?
Only if the cotton's wet.
What's heavier, a pound of cotton or a pound of stones?
Same size. Same size. Same weight. Sorry.
Yeah, you got it. There are 30 cows and 28 chickens. How many didn't?
Two.
There are 30 cows and 28 chickens. How many didn't?
Two.
Why two?
Because the difference between 30 and 28.
I didn't ask about the difference. I said how many didn't.
Two.
It's not right. There are 30 cows and 28 chickens. How many didn't? He doesn't get tricked, though.
Michael Quinn, I don't get tricked easily. Didn't what?
There are 30 cows and 28 chickens. How many didn't?
How many?
Pretty simple question.
There are 30 cows and 28 chickens. Oh, 28 of them didn't because they're chicken. Wait, what do you mean? What's the question?
You just said it. What? You just said the question. Say it again.
There are 30 cows and 28 chickens.
Yeah, 28 chickens.
How many didn't?
The answer is 10. What do you mean? 28 chickens. 28 chickens.
Oh.
There are 30 cows and 28 chickens. How many didn't?
Bro,
the answer is 10.
What? How?
So there are 30 cows, yeah, and 20 of them ate chickens.
Dude, come on, stop playing me like that.
You add the 4, take away 24, plus a 2, divide by pi,
which would be
10.
Oh. Spell top.
T-O-P.
Say top 2 times.
Top, top.
Say top 3 times.
Top, top, top.
Say cop 4 times really fast.
Cop, 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 cop.
What do you do to green light?
Stop. Oh.
Spell top.
T-O-P.
Say top twice.
Top, top.
Say cop 3 times.
Cop, cop, cop.
Say cop 4 times fast.
Cop, 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 cop.
What do you do to green light?
Stop. Oh.
Spell top.
T-O-P.
Say top 2 times.
Cop, top.
Say cop 3 times.
Cop, 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 cop.
Say cop 4 times fast.
Cop, 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 cop.
What do you do to green light?
Stop, go.
Which one? Say cop 4 times fast.
Cop, 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 cop.
What do you do to green light?
Go.
Alright. Say silk 3 times fast.
Silk, silk, silk.
What do cows drink?
Milk.
Silk 3 times.
Silk, silk, silk.
What do cows drink?
Milk.
Oh! Your mom has 4 kids. North, south, and east. What's the 4th child's name?
Terry.
Why Terry?
Why not?
Nah, you're the 4th child, unless your name's Terry. I thought it was John Kent. Your mom has 4 kids. North, south, and east. What's the 4th child's name?
West.
He wasn't actually born. He just... Wait, isn't your name Liam? Or your mom has 4 kids. I guess you're like the kid that everyone forgot about. How many terms did Benjamin Franklin serve as president?
One.
One term?
Yeah.
Why? Because it's only a $100 bill?
Nah, he wasn't. Was he not a president?
Benjamin Franklin wasn't a president. How many terms did Benjamin Franklin serve as president?
100? Is that what I'm supposed to say? I think he only served one.
One?
But he was not president.
4 years, right?
Yeah, 4 years.
Benjamin Franklin wasn't a president, actually. But it's all right.
I thought the trick was supposed to say 100.
There wasn't a trick there. I just asked you how many terms did Benjamin Franklin serve as president, and you thought he was a president. The farmer has 15 sheep. All but 8 died. How many are left?
0.
Where'd you get 0 from?
Reset the question.
All right. A farmer has 15 sheep. All but 8 died. How many are left?
7.
All but 8 died.
All right, you got.
All right. So the answer is 8 because, as I said, how many are left? I said all but 8. Which means 8 are alive. All but 8 died. So not 8 people. So there are 8 left.
All right.
A farmer has 15 sheep. All but 8 died. How many are left?
7.
7? What the?
A farmer had 15 sheep and all but 8 died?
Yeah.
Oh, there's only 1 left because one of them was 8. No. 8.
All but 8. 15. Died.
All 15.
All but 8. Like, everyone but 8 died. How many are left?
Everyone but 8 died. What is that?
So that means 8 are left. All but 8. So everyone died except for 8. 8 of them. 8 are left.
8 are left.
8 are left.
Michael Quinn. I don't get tricked easily.
Farmer has 15 sheep. All but 8 died. How many are left?
104? No.
No, it's like 1 minus 8. 8 minus 1.
9? No.
No, no, no. I'm trying again. Other way.
7.
Yeah, that's not the right answer, though. The correct answer is actually 8, because all but 8, you know? There are 10 apples in a bin. You take out 4. How many do you have?
You still have 10.
Nope.
Yeah.
Want to say it again?
Yeah.
There are 10 apples in a bin. You take out four. How many do you have?
Four.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. There are 10 apples in a bin. You take out four. How many do you have?
Six. How many do you have?
Total
10. How many do you have in the bin? Six.
Do you need to clarify? That's very...
I said, how many do you have?
Well, I mean, it depends if I kept the other four in my hand.
So what's the answer?
Well, I mean, in my hand, I would have four, but in...
I'll ask the question again. There are 10 apples in a bin.
Who owns the bin?
There's just... Nobody owns the bin. It's just the bin. There are 10 apples in a bin. You take out four. How many do you have?
I mean, a bin has to be produced. Somebody made the bin. Somebody owns the bin. It's important.
All right, sure. It's like...
Somebody else's bin, because it's not yours. If it was your bin, then those would be your apples.
You're missing the point of the question. I asked, how many do you have?
In my hand, four.
That was the question. It was, there are 10 apples in a bin. You take out four. How many do you have?
Well, if the bin's yours, you have 10.
All right, now you have four. A rooster laid an egg on top of the barn roof. Which way did it roll?
Down.
It didn't roll down. The answer actually is, roosters don't lay eggs. So there was no egg to start with, so the answer was, rooster has no eggs. A rooster laid an egg on top of the roof. Which way did it roll?
On top of the roof?
Yeah, a rooster laid an egg on top of the roof. Which way did the egg roll?
Didn't roll.
Why not? Why wouldn't it roll? It's a curved roof like that.
I don't know, cracked?
Roosters don't lay eggs, bro. Like, you should know this. You're, like, getting older, okay? You're almost 16, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. You got to know this stuff by now, okay? All right. How can a man go 8 days without sleeping?
He doesn't go to bed.
He does go to bed. Everyone has to go to bed. Come on.
But if it's 8 days without sleeping, then he doesn't go to
bed. Well, actually, he sleeps at nights.
But if he sleeps at night.
He doesn't sleep during the days. He sleeps at night. He sleeps 8 nights. How can a man go 8 days without sleep?
How can a man go 8 days without sleep? He's dead.
Nah. So, like, the same thing that I would do, and most likely you would do, I'd go to sleep at night.
Wait, what?
How can a man go 8 days without sleep?
Aw, that's so...
Spell roast.
R-O-A-S-T.
Say coast 2 times.
Coast, coast.
Say roast 3 times.
Roast, roast, roast.
Say coast 4 times fast.
Coast, 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 coast.
What do you put in a toaster?
Toast.
Spell coast.
C-O-A-S-T.
Say coast twice.
Coast, coast.
Say roast 3 times.
Roast, roast, roast.
Say roast 4 times fast.
Roast, 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 roast.
What do you put in a toaster? Time's up by now.
I mean, I want to say toast, but like...
Even after all that thinking, you still thought it was toast.
What do you put in a toaster?
Yeah.
Bread.
So funny. Those riddles made my day.
I'm glad you enjoyed it. And on that note, this concludes this week's episode. I'm Ben Packer.
And I'm Lindsay Santella, and this has been
Under the Rock.